The shutdown has shut down the president. It's the 22nd day of the partial government shutdown, making it the longest in American history. Yesterday, thousands of federal workers received paychecks for $0 as a wave of anxiety washed over countless families who wonder how they will pay their bills. No problem for Trump, though. He says he's proud to shut the government down and will keep it shut down for years if he has to. Earlier this week, in what looked like a hostage video, he gave a stilted, scripted address from the Oval Office, laying out his case for a deal with Democrats on border wall funding. They did not budge. Hindered but undeterred, he began floating the idea of declaring a national emergency to fund his border wall. But he faced a lukewarm response from Republicans who rightly worried about the precedent of using American taxpayer dollars and maybe even the military to, you know, get what Congress won't give you. Well, that didn't seem to work. Okay, what next? Well, the White House reportedly started looking into whether or not Trump could fund his wall with $13.9 billion that had been allocated last year to hurricane victims. Boy, this guy is desperate, ain't he? Okay, seemingly out of options, the president finally said, screw it, let's see if this works.
When during the campaign, I would say Mexico's going to pay for it. Obviously, I never said this and I never meant they're gonna write out a check.
Yep, you did.
Mexico is going to pay for the wall.
Mexico will pay for the wall.
And Mexico's going to pay for the wall.
And who's gonna pay for the wall?
Mexico!
And who's gonna pay for the wall?
Okay, but don't count him out just yet. Trump's a real estate guy. He knows how to negotiate. What do you do when your $5 billion wall isn't selling? You lower the price, of course. According to Fox & Friends host Steve Doocy, Trump will now, quote, take anything in the twos. Got a big wall, lots of light, prime border location in the twos? That's a bargain, Democrats. Okay, here's the deal. This is what losing looks like. Mr. President, you've lost this one. You're not getting your $5.7 billion border wall, not from Mexico, not from Congress, and I'm willing to wager not from taxpayers either. It's a shame, too, because when you had the opportunity, the public support, Republicans in control of Congress, Democrats against the proverbial wall, you couldn't get it done. Why? Too much tweeting, too much rallying, not enough governing. So now it's time to accept the loss and move on to what's next. I have some ideas. I happened by your tweet from earlier today. I just watched a fake reporter from the Amazon Washington Post say the White House is chaotic. There does not seem to be a strategy for this shutdown. There is no plan. The fakes always like talking chaos. There is none. In fact, there's almost nobody in the White House but me. You know, I've always found my alone time to be some of my most productive. Use this me time, Mr. President. Get back in touch with you. Try meditating. Get centered. Yoga helps clear the mind. Or how about a vision board where you paste pictures of all the things you'd like to accomplish this year? I got you started. Here's a picture of a wall. And here's a picture of you signing a bill into a law. Put those up on your vision board. Think it. Whatever you do, the most important lesson is when you fall off a horse, or fail to deliver on a key promise despite having total control of Washington, you get back on the horse. You don't declare a national emergency and make taxpayers pay for the horse. Good life lesson. Okay, let's discuss the latest on the shutdown and the border fight with Maryland Senator Ben Cardin. Senator Cardin, let me start with that idea that the president would take anything with a two in front of it for the wall. I don't know if that's true. Fox and Friends host Steve Doocy said it was. I'll ask you, though, would you support $2 billion something in funding for a border wall?
Well, first, let me say government needs to be opened. What the president is doing in shutting government is hurting people. It's hurting our country. He's holding America hostage. I met yesterday with a large number of government workers who are really hurting with not being able to get a check. It's affecting their family, it's affecting their credit, it's affecting their lives. This is serious business.
Yeah.
So government needs to be opened. So your answer is, how do you reach a compromise with President Trump? It's difficult when he's holding America hostage. It's difficult when he undermines his own negotiators. But clearly, we believe in border security. So yes, we're willing to talk about border security. We know that we need additional resources spent on border security. The president's got to get away from the wall. But there is a way in which we could work out border security issues. But open government. Don't hold the government. Don't hold our country hostage.
So 5 years ago, I know you know this, Democrats supported a bill that required the construction of 700 miles of border fencing. Every single Democrat voted for it, including you. So is it just now that the politics has shifted? Democrats hold more cards and can get more for what they want.
No, of course, as you point out, that was not fencing. It wasn't a wall from coast to coast.
Yeah.
It was part of an overall border security issue. We were dealing with other issues as well in regards to immigration reform. So there was a lot more involved than what we're trying to get done. And we're willing to talk about that. We want comprehensive immigration reform. Absolutely. But you can't do it while government is shuttered. You can't do it when people's lives are being adversely affected by the president's arbitrary decision not to sign bills that pass both the House and Senate. What we asked Mr. McConnell to do is pass bills that had already passed the Senate in order to open up government. And some agencies, most agencies, are not even involved in this fight. It's ridiculous.
So, well, I think it's safe to say that the American people, as of now, hold the president responsible for this shutdown. He asked them to. But I do think that they will tire of this game of chicken eventually. Do you think Democrats at some point will say, enough, we'll come to the table, we'll fund a wall and get this government running again? Or do you not see that happening?
I just think it's impossible to negotiate with a president who's holding you hostage and changes his mind every few minutes, undermines his own negotiators. We want to get government open. We'll do anything reasonable to get government open. But clearly the president's the one who's stopping it. And we could have opened it up already if Mitch McConnell would have allowed a vote on the floor of the Senate. We think we had the votes in the Senate not only to pass the bills we previously passed, but by margins that would be enough for a veto override. So there's a way forward to Congress acting as a co-equal branch of government, doing its work. We can open up government. And yes, we will provide border security.
Senator Ben Cardin, thanks so much for coming on. I appreciate it.